All right, good job. So what I want you to do now, we've only got 3 minutes. What I want you to do is I want you to have a little think, if you have any questions that you want to ask me. Is there anything that I haven't shown you that you want to know? Oh, good, I've got 5 minutes. I love you. You gave me 2 extra minutes. So have a little think. Is there something that you wanted to know that you haven't seen? Is there something that you thought, I really hope I learned this in this session and I haven't said it or talked about it? So let's go to a few questions and see if I can help out in any way. Oh, so really good question as well. So the B skip is for hurdlers and jumpers. So if I'm a jumper, I'm running, I'm hitting the board, and I'm up and I'm over and I'm lengthening. So doing the B skip, you can see them, I've done them all in my lifetime. Doing the B skip, we'll eccentrically load the hamstring and pull it down as a straight lever. If I'm a hurdler or a jumper, I'm going to be doing that. Now, there's some strength and conditioning coaches who debate with me and they'll say, well, I do the B skip because I do it for eccentric loading of the hamstring and I want to develop that tension under length. And I say, if you're doing it for that specific reason, then I'm not going to debate you, that's fine. But in terms of technical mechanics of running, that's not the drill that you should be doing. But if you're doing it to strengthen the hamstring, that's your choice, not a problem. Yeah, good question. Any others?